evening and welcome to Arizona Horizon. I'm Ted Simons. Governor Brewer today defended her decision to deny driver's licenses and other state benefits to young immigrants granted temporary legal status by the federal government. The governor said that she has compassion for those brought here illegally at a young age, but she said it was their parents' responsibility to follow the law. The governor said that she does not hate Hispanics or immigrants, and she called on the federal government to secure the border. Phoenix Mayor Greg Stanton took part in a trade mission to Mexico last week. Stanton was accompanied by the mayor of Tucson, along with a number of Phoenix City government and business leaders. And here to talk about the trip and other topics is Phoenix Mayor Greg Stanton. Good to see you. Thanks for joining us.
Glad to be back.
All right. The trade mission to Mexico, what was the focus here?
Opening doors. The reality is I'm going to be focused as mayor on jobs and economic development. I said during my State of the City that I was going to go to Mexico again and again to build those relationships. They're our number one trading partner, and that relationship, trade relationship, economic relationship needs to go nowhere but up. And I, as mayor, am going to use my bully pulpit in partnership with the Tucson mayor in this case to open as many doors as I can to support our businesses. So the purpose of the mission was to get down there, have our business leaders meet business leaders down there, look for areas of mutual opportunity, but also send a message from the city leadership of this state. And that message is this: we want your business, we love diversity, we need to partner with you. Your success and our success are related to each other. We can't succeed without you, and you can't succeed without us. And so we need to build the strongest economic relationships that we can, and that's going to be my focus as mayor.
Was that message lost in the kerfuffle, if you will, regarding SB 1070 and immigration in general?
The reality is that some of the positions that have been taken here in the state of Arizona, positions that have left the impression that this state is divisive and doesn't respect and embrace the diverse communities here, has hurt us in Mexico. Certainly on the tourism side, it has hurt us. And has made some folks less willing really to open their minds when it comes to dealing with Arizona. And my message is, you know, to the extent that there have been things that have been passed that have been divisive, that doesn't really represent the majority of Arizonans. I grew up in Phoenix, and I represent the largest city in the state of Arizona. And the city that I represent, we love the diversity here. We embrace it. We want to do business with our friends in Mexico. We understand that our growing Latino population, over 40% of our city, is a strategic economic advantage, and I plan to take full advantage of that population.
How often, when you met with folks down there, how often was immigration enforcement, the whole nine yards, how often was immigration in general mentioned among business and government leaders down there?
It's mentioned regularly. They pay close attention to what happens in the political environment in the United States of America. And so to the extent that tourists have choices about which communities they're going to visit, states that embrace diversity, that they feel don't engage in divisive language, they're the states that the people in Mexico are going to want to spend their time and money in. Look, I've taken the position, and I believe from the bottom of my heart, that being pro-people is pro-business. And I'm not naive about immigration. We have to have a stronger border policy. We have to pass comprehensive immigration reform. I believe that passing the DREAM Act will be help our Arizona economy by getting those young people onto college. We need more college graduates in our community. So we could be tough on the border and be smart about immigration policy and still have a great business and trade relationship with Mexico. Those are not inconsistent with each other. In fact, I would argue they are exactly consistent with each other.
Last point on the trip. I understand that the impression of Tucson among government and business leaders in Mexico, a little more favorable than the impression of Phoenix. Accurate?
I think that is, it is accurate. We're going to do, over my time as mayor, we're going to send that message that all of Arizona really does embrace our diverse communities. That to the extent that these divisive things have occurred, they don't represent the majority of Arizonans. They don't represent the majority of the people in my city. But the other message we sent is, as cities, we're going to lead. You know, to the extent that maybe passage of divisive legislation has set us behind a little bit from tourism and some of the trade relationships, as mayors, we don't care about any of that stuff. We care about jobs. We care about economic development. We're going to do right by the people of our communities. And so cities are not going to wait for anybody else to lead. We're going to lead. And it was important that you saw a strong partnership, myself and Michael Nowakowski from our Phoenix City Council representing Phoenix, and Mayor Rothschild of Tucson. Phoenix and Tucson are not rivals in this regard. We're partners when it comes to increasing trade with our friends in Mexico.
You refer to in-state tuition. I know that you think that that tuition should be offered to kids who are eligible for the deferred action status, these so-called Dream Act, ERSAT's Dream Act kids. Why do you say that when critics will say it's really not necessarily fair that American-born kids are, you know, have the same kind of situation going, A, and B, the state really can't afford this?
I want as many people in this community to graduate high school and move on to college as possible. People who view higher education as a static entity are wrong. We want more people graduating high school. We want more people demanding entrance into college. Maricopa Community Colleges, Arizona State Universities, we want these to be growing institutions, not static institutions. The more we can get these young people who came here at a young age at someone else's decision, who are making the right choices, graduating from high school and moving on to college, the more we can get them into institutions of higher education, long term, the better our economy will be here. And with regard to those so-called Dream Act kids, you know, they have, it's a diverse population, obviously. It's a bilingual population. They understand and appreciate cultural differences in Mexico and Latin America. And as we engage in international trade, particularly with that part of the world, that will be a strategic economic advantage for our country. Again, as mayors, we're going to leave divisive politics for others. We're going to take positions, and I'm certainly going to take positions, that I believe are in the long-term best economic interest of this community. And I think getting young people educated is a really smart economic decision.
But there are some who say that particular position ignores the law. The law says that these folks aren't citizens and shouldn't get in-state tuition. The governor just today basically said that she feels bad for them, but she's blaming their parents for putting them in this position in the first place. How do you respond?
Well, I've taken a position that I support the Dream Act because it's good economic policy for our city and long-term for our state. Again, I want to get as many young people in this community, and these are young people that came here at a young age that have grown up in this community. I don't want to engage in divisive policy. I want to engage in smart policy and getting as many young people as possible, Dream Act kids or other young people in this community. I want all young people in this community to have a full and fair opportunity to get that college education. We are not going to be competitive in this international economy if we don't increase the college attainment of our workforce. So again, I'll leave divisive policies for others. As mayor of the city, I'm going to embrace the policies that support our long-term economic strength.
Last point on this. A work permit equals in-state status for tuition, correct?
I believe so. Yeah,
yes.
That is correct.
So
yeah.
If you're authorized and you get a work permit, wouldn't these folks get the in-state tuition regardless of what the governor has ordered?
I'll let those much smarter than I, who are lawyers in the field of immigration, tell you the legal answer to that. The position that I'm going to take is what's in our economic interest. So I'm going to support public policies that maximize the chances for our young people to achieve their dream of a college education and, more importantly, achieve what's in the best long-term economic interest of this community. We got to be smart about public policy if Arizona is going to compete in the international economy, and that's exactly what I plan to do.
The impact of a possible merger, U.S. Airways and American Airlines, what are you seeing there? Well, how's it going to hit Phoenix and the Valley and Sky Harbor in particular? What's going on here?
Well, Mayor Mitchell of Tempe and I are friends and colleagues and partners, and together we met with Doug Parker and the leadership team at U.S. Airways to ask those very questions, to let them know that, hey, the public should know what your plans are if the merger is successful. Mr. Parker was clear that the merger is not a done deal, that it has to go through bankruptcy court, and there's a lot of steps along the way that have to occur. But if, in fact, the merger does occur, that Phoenix Sky Harbor would remain the key Western regional hub for this new airline. As you know, there's consolidation going on in the airline industry. It's critically important that we keep those flights in and out of Sky Harbor because our success in business, internationally and nationally, is directly related to how well we provide air service in our region. So that commitment to keep Phoenix as the Western regional hub is really important to the business environment here in Phoenix.
What about jobs? Lost, perhaps some jobs gained.
We don't know. I think the agreement was made with American that if the merger goes through, The corporate leaders at the corporate headquarters would be in Texas. We asked for and received a commitment that as they consolidate operations, Phoenix and Tempe would have a fair opportunity to compete for those jobs. That's what we want. We want an opportunity to compete. If we get a fair opportunity, I believe that this region will successfully compete. I've been dealing a lot with the aerospace and defense industry. There's a lot of consolidation going on in that industry. When I talk to corporate leaders, I say, as you consolidate, think about Phoenix as a region that is business friendly and ready to have you have your expanded operations. And we've been successful in that regard. I view what's going on with U.S. Airways as the same exact opportunity. If given the opportunity to compete, our region will compete successfully.
Last question. Broken nose. How'd that happen? What's going on there?
Well, you know, I played high school basketball, and I still haven't fully given up my hoop dream. So I was offered a great opportunity to play with some outstanding professional basketball players in this area, the Phoenix Mercury, our two-time champion Phoenix Mercury. And I took that opportunity, and I thought they were going to take it easy on me. Yeah. That was not the case. So I ended up with exactly what I deserved, which is a broken nose by an outstanding power forward named Nakia Stanford. I was waiting for the rebound. The ball was coming. All of a sudden, I see the shadow rising over me. She grabbed the ball, and her elbow ended up on my nose. So I was trying to get them a little publicity. I had no idea how much publicity I was going to get over this. But you know what? Injuries are part of the game, and
I accept that,
and I was out on the court, and that's what comes with it.
Got to play hurt, but I got to tell you, the mayor of Phoenix, this is a high-risk job. We had Mayor Phil Gordon falling out of a tree, I believe, a few years ago. Now you're breaking your nose. Goodness gracious, what's going on in that
office? I would never want to be critical of a past mayor, but I will just say it's much cooler to be injured playing hoops than it is falling out of a tree. Mayor Gordon, if you're watching.
All right, we will leave it at that. Mayor, good to have you here. Thanks for joining
us. Thanks for having me on.